Thank you all for coming out today. We're here on a very important issue, hospital closure reform. It was a short time ago when all of a sudden we found out that there was going to be a hospital closure. That hospital closure was First Hospital in Kingston, Pennsylvania, across the river from my district. And no one knew about it, and everyone was shocked.
When someone needs emergency care, every second counts. Even a 1 minute increase in travel time during a life or death situation can increase mortality rates.
Communities facing hospital closures need more time, more input, and more information.
These challenges create immense barriers to some of our residents accessing vital health care.
Our intent is to correct an issue which is life-threatening.
These efforts are welcome and they are greatly needed.
Across Pennsylvania, we're already struggling with timely access to care, and these closures, whether full or partial, only exacerbate that.
And we understand, you know, the business, the operation, we understand that changes are made and things change in time. The bottom line is how we make those changes. So as a result, Representative O'Meara and I worked hard on developing our proposal. And even before we got started, Senator Kmita had her proposal up and running. These things would not have been done without certain people, and I'd like to recognize them now. Adam Cerucci and Emily Eister, Legislative Director for Senator Kmita. Randy Miller, he's the Southeast Delegation Director in support of Representative O'Meara, and Will Hughes, who's my research analyst. All of them did a fantastic job in helping us write these bills. Our doors are open to the Hospital Association to discuss this issue and come up with solutions, but there's no way that government can just sit back and do nothing.